It's slam-alicious is what it is. So thank you. This is Sarah's contact information here if you want to take a picture of that. And we'll keep this party moving. But before we do, I have prizes. So Sarah, why don't you come up and get your VR glasses? Ooh. Okay, so that's a brand new VR glasses. We also have a notebook from Twitter. Ooh. And a notebook from Washington Business Journal. Thank you. Close. Thank you so much, Sarah. Awesome. All right, keeping this party moving. How's Oscar doing with the drinks? Good? Good? Let's give a whoop. Let's have a whoop whoop for Oscar. I just buzzed myself. Okay. All right. All right. All right, let's give it up for Simon Locke. Simon is founder and CEO of communicationsmatch.com. Simon is speaking about the title of his session, his five-minute session, is Why Don't We Hire Agencies Like We Hire Employees? Simon, there you go. Oh, we go the wrong way?
I have no idea.
There we go.
Yeah. All right.
Let's give it up, Simon.
Yay, Simon.
Wow. It's a little on the intimidating side, so okay. So I used to run communications functions for Deutsche Bank, Morgan Stanley, Prudential Financial. I was based in Singapore, Tokyo, New York, and lucky me, Newark, New Jersey. So one of the things that when we were hiring experienced employees, experienced communicators, was we had a process. Okay. We had a process. And the process was we might actually engage, we would certainly engage HR, we would engage internal or external recruiters. And in that process, we'd probably maybe get 100 resumes. That was a pretty thorough process. We would then look through them, and we would actually choose maybe 10 to 20 qualified candidates for interviews. Then we'd go through our second round, and on that second round, maybe we ended up with about 3 kind of preferred candidates. We'd probably then go to our business partners and have them interview the candidates. And certainly before we hired them, we would actually check references. So what do we do when we hire agencies? Well, one of the first questions actually is, why do we go through that process when we're hiring employees? Because we know it's really important. And actually the data kind of shows us that there's a lot of money at stake when we get these decisions wrong. So what do we do when we hire agencies? Well, actually, we've just done some research with RFP Associates and ResearchGate, and we kind of got some of the answers. The first one is there are 3 main takeaways from the research, and the first one was that when companies hire agencies, they generally don't use a fairly comprehensive process. That actually, somewhere more than 3/4 of the leaders that we surveyed basically said, we rely on our own judgment to choose the agencies that we want to have in our candidate pool. And 2/3 basically said, we rely on word of mouth to be able to find the firms that might fit. And how many do we get to out of that process? About 2 to 5 candidates for an agency search. Now, I don't know if anyone would argue that if you're hiring $1 million or $500,000 agency, that's not an important decision. That may actually cost you more than several employees. Now, just to be balanced about this, so you know how are agencies doing? Because we also looked at how agencies are doing and how clients saw the agency response in the survey process. And the answer was companies felt agencies were upselling, delivering boilerplate responses, and actually more often than not actually providing proposals that really matched what they were looking for. So look, at the end of the day, the agency leaders and heads of communications are smart people. You know, it's not like we're dummies making these decisions, but what they are doing is taking shortcuts. And the reality is, you know, that shortcuts are a bit of a problem. Now, in fact, there's something in behavioral science called the scarcity principle. Now, actually, there are a couple of versions of it, but the scarcity idea is that when things are scarce, for us, it's time and money, that we tend to kind of go into tunnels. We actually are not particularly good at looking at the long-term consequences of the decisions that we make. And as a result, you know, we don't necessarily do the smartest things at that particular moment in time. Now, the research shows us a few things that were really kind of important. One is that from a satisfaction perspective with agencies, what we saw is that when a company went through a thorough process, the satisfaction when they were joining was much higher. What we also saw was that when you have a thorough process, satisfaction is also higher. So, and the other thing is, here's the interesting connection, longevity. You are more likely to have a longer relationship with an agency when the search process has been thorough. Oh, I've forgotten to forward any of my slides along, but that's okay. Okay, here we go. Boom, boom, we're going to go to the end. Scarcity principle. Okay, putting the pieces together. What are the takeaways for companies? Takeaways for companies are relatively straightforward, which is look at the employee hiring process and apply those rules when we're hiring agencies. Cast the net wide. Look more broadly. Have a process for actually evaluating the candidates who are coming in. And then lastly, make sure that you're actually engaging with your business partners and others associated with it. So I'm going to do the last thing for an agency. The last thing for an agency is don't do boilerplate responses. Don't upsell. Provide what the company is looking for. There is a punchline. And here's the punchline. When you do the search more thoroughly, you will get better results. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, Simon Locke. Simon Locke from communicationsmatch.com. Brilliant. Just love it so much. Love it. Okay, so we'll keep it moving. If you're in the back, come.